It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday. I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig.
And this is the Wizard Product Review. And on this week's show... Now, first up this week is Cirque du Flea by Daniel Cross. It's not a long DVD. It's sort of 26 minutes.
Got to be honest. And when you first told me about this, I said he's going to have to convince me. I'm just not a big fan of flea circuses. I just can't see the point.
Well, I went to the FISM in the Den Haag many, many years ago, and I hadn't really seen flea circuses, and there was this guy there. He had this oldie-worldy, like, flea circus. It was absolutely superb. This thing was, like, $2,000 or something.
Right.
But it was brilliant. It had got the cannon and that kind of thing. And there were some of the most knowledgeable magicians in the world crowding around this guy watching this flea circus.
And I bet you wanted to buy it, didn't you?
I did want to buy it. I couldn't afford it at the time. I was so into it. And everyone was loving it. And everyone was like, people like Greg Wilson were just there just cheering and loving this thing.
Okay.
And I was really actually looking forward to seeing this DVD because I was looking forward to kind of getting some insights into a flea circus.
Right.
But that's kind of not what it is it?
No. I mean, I said, okay, let's put this DVD on and you can try and prove me wrong. I've got this whole thing where I think flea circuses, I can't see the point. And you put this on, I watched the whole 22 minutes, and at the end of the 22 minutes...
26
minutes, sorry. Can't remember.
Don't
short
change him.
Those last 4 minutes. And at the end of the 26 minutes, I was bored to tears. It was just terrible.
Well, you know, it follows the kind of same format as most sort of flea circuses do, where they do
is
sort of tricks.
Is entertaining? Because the DVD is a presentation of Daniel Cross's flea circus act. I mean, basically, the full 26 minutes is just that.
He's videoing it to camera, isn't he? Camera, and it keeps zooming in every now and then.
Is that really as impressive as a flea circus presentation
gets? Well, normally,
gets?
It can be a bit... I'm sure it's better live, a bit better atmosphere, but you see certain tricks, like you see the coin flip, and that was the first thing on the DVD, and it's basically convinces you that the flea is flipping over the coin. It doesn't look that good, really.
No,
does
not
it?
Really.
It looks okay, but not great.
I mean, I've not really seen a flea circus before, but all of the tricks, the tightrope, I've got them written down here, the tightrope, the shooting the flea out the cannon, the high dive, all those different things.
Well, he finds a card, basically. So you've got the flea finds a card and it matches a prediction. So he's combining that with magic. Then you see the flea doing sort of soccer skills and that kind of thing, and he puts the little goal there and the flea's moving the football around. It does look good when you see the flea at the end and he kind of takes it out of the pot and he goes, give him a round of applause.
But he does it at the end of every single thing.
Yeah, he does the same thing every single time.
It's so boring. Even you halfway through were like, right, I've had enough now.
Yeah, the tightrope thing looks pretty good. The high dive is a bit of a classic in flea circuses.
That actually looked really good.
Where he actually dives, you see the diving board going up and down and up and down, then it jumps in there. And a bit with a psychic slate.
I just think,
okay.
This is what I think, Dave. What I think is... I think that toys for children have become so advanced now with so many working parts. And you go in Toys R Us and you go, wow, this stuff is amazing.
Yeah.
I just think if any average 7, 8, 9, 10-year-old watch this, they'd instantly know exactly how it works because they've probably got toys that they can buy from toy shops that do roughly the same thing.
Yeah,
in which case, what's the point?
I did think as a flea circus, it didn't really have that much charm and the props didn't look as good as this thing I'd seen in...
What I thought was hilarious, mate. At about 18 minutes in, his presentation ended, and it cut to kind of...
Well, hang on, we thought right, the show's over, didn't we? You have to remember how we felt at this time. So, as with most magic DVDs, you normally have the bit where you watch the performance, and then you have the bit after where they go, right, this is how it all works, and if you're going to do a flea circus yourself, this is what you need to think about. No. In all seriousness, he looks at the camera and he talks about how you actually train fleas.
Yeah,
and
complete with slides.
He's deadly serious as well.
Which fleas to get, where to find them.
Yeah, his granddad apparently was infested with fleas.
And you can only use human fleas because they're the only ones that you can train.
And then he goes into harnesses, different flea harnesses.
And then the best one ever was how to feed them.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And then he had the blood.
He puts the blood on his hand and the flea goes around like this. And then the DVD ends.
Yeah, I don't know what it's aimed at, because he doesn't teach you how to make a flea circus. He doesn't teach you how to perform it beyond the performance on the DVD. He doesn't teach you how any of that stuff works. He literally sits down in front of his camera and his wife spends 26 minutes filming him doing the flea circus and then answering some pseudo questions. I don't see
it's not really
who would buy this or why.
It's not really a teaching aid for magicians. What this looks like to me is if Daniel was out doing his bookings and he's done his show and people have really enjoyed it, you know, they've enjoyed the show, and he perhaps sells these after the show.
Yeah.
I could see that.
No, I completely agree. I could see that making sense. But why is it being made available to magicians and being sent into the Wizard Product Review? And it doesn't say anything like that. It doesn't say that you're not going to get a full explanation. It talks about how Daniel Cross is one of the best performers in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
And this is a one-of-a-kind full feature-length presenter. It doesn't say that it's not a teaching aid.
It doesn't.
It's very, very misrepresented.
I was actually looking
respect.
Forward to this, having seen flea circuses before, having enjoyed them. I didn't think this was up to the standard of flea circuses that I'd seen before, and I didn't really learn anything. I was just watching him do his show, and then I did feel a little bit patronised at the end. I'll give it 29%.
I'll give it 0%. I didn't learn anything, and just, I can't see any point for it. 0%.
Right, just before the next review, just want to make it clear that the last DVD, Daniel Cross's Flea, is part of a two DVD set.
Yep.
But the other disc hasn't got anything to do with fleas on there.
It's got nothing to do with flea circuses. It's his close-up magic.
Yeah, but you get two together. So we'll have a look at that one perhaps next week.
Well, really? That'll be fun.
We might do, but we've reviewed just the one DVD this week.
Fair enough.
That's all we could say, really. But on to the next one, which is Tony Clark's Gypsy Balloon.
We've been waiting for this for a long time.
We've been getting a little...
The spin failed.
Brilliant. Doesn't matter, I'll cover it with video.
Really?
Yeah. Right, so Gypsy Balloon. It's basically gypsy thread, but very, very artistic.
Yeah, I was a little bit worried. I've been looking forward to this, but I was a little bit worried because I was thinking, well, I hope there's going to be something more to it than just taking the classic gypsy thread and tying a balloon on the end. And there is a lot more to it, isn't
there? There's a lot more to it. It's hard to kind of go into how good it actually is.
But it's very clever.
Yeah, theatrically, this thing is absolutely stunning. It's beautiful. Obviously, Tony's put his full presentation on here. You get two live performances, don't you?
Two full live performances, and one with a child coming up and one without.
It's absolutely beautiful. He's got this balloon and he kind of says, every show there's different things, there's been laughter, there's been amazement, and every single time he says a word, he breaks the piece of thread.
Yeah.
You do get thread with it as well, special thread that you can easily break. You can get more off his website, but I think you'd be able to source the thread.
Oh, easily, yeah.
Quite easily.
You go
anyway.
To a haberdashery or something like that and just tell them what you're looking for.
You just need thread that you can break, but it's a good thing that you do actually get a sample of the thread,
so you can practice straight away
in there, so you can do it straight away. It's a lot cleverer than we thought it was going
to
be.
Yeah, it takes probably about 2 or 3 minutes to prep the balloon. Once it's prepped, you can come out with it. You can do it any time you want to, and it's once you've got it prepped and you're ready to go, it's completely
animal-proof. And the thing I want to stress, the thing I was worried about, which wasn't clear on the promotional trailer, and it's better than that, is when you come out with the balloon at the start, literally you've just got the one bit of string.
And that's it.
Just the one bit of string going 5 foot up to the knot where it's then tied on.
Yeah.
And that's it. It's a completely clean piece of string that you could handle like this, and then you proceed to break it and perform the standard gypsy thread. And when the music kicks in at the end and that balloon just rises by itself.
And Tony actually uses this as a closer to his stage shows. He actually uses it as a closer, which just shows how much he thinks of it. And you loved it from a theatrical point of view.
I loved it. Well, the theatrics of the balloon going up, it's naturally going to lift an audience. It's a lot better than this.
You know, I think it would also work really well for a kid's show. If you get the birthday child to come up.
It is fantastic.
And you give them the balloon as a thing at the end for them to keep. you could even, if you wanted to, do it close up. I mean, once it's prepped, you could have five or six of these balloons prepped in your car. And if you go over to a table where there's a special person that you really want to impress, maybe there's a chance to get in a booking, say, hey, I've got something for you. Run and get and the balloon out of the car and do it for them on their table.
These days as well, you can get balloons that say anything. Happy anniversary. Completely, they can say anything. And then you give it away at the end.
And you get a little helium tank, which you can keep in your car, which will do probably 30 or so balloons. You can prep it in 2 minutes' notice. You can almost do it on the fly. It's just a great trick. I think it's really, really good.
It's a beautiful piece of magic. This is not a trick.
No.
Tricks are what you do for your mates down the pub. This is a beautiful piece of magic.
Yeah.
Theatrically, it's stunning. The method is very clever.
Yeah.
Obviously, Tony's worked it.
Yeah.
It's not a really long DVD.
It's also very easy to do.
But it doesn't need to be. The moves you're going to have to do are very, very basic.
If you already do the gypsy thread, you'll be able to do this immediately. If you don't do the gypsy thread, well, it's only going to take... It's easier than the classic gypsy thread, actually, when you think about
it. Yeah, it probably works. Is.
It's easier than the classic gypsy thread. It'll take you hardly any time to learn to do it.
It looks beautiful. It's a beautifully stunning piece of magic.
You're going to do it, aren't you?
I'm going to do this. I'm giving it 95%.
I'm giving it 94%. Well done, Tony Clark. Okay, so I've got a trick now to show you. You haven't seen this. We're going to play a little game, you and me. It's the Wizard Product Review guessing game, okay? I'm going to show you a trick, and you've got to guess who the creator is.
It's not Alan Wong, is it?
No, it's not Alan Wong. I'm not touching any of his stuff after those jade rings from hell. No, I'm going to show you a trick.
Right, okay.
The only clue I'm going to give you is we've reviewed his stuff before on the Wizard Product Review.
Yeah.
I'm going to show
you. You're going to do it for us.
I'm going to get it off the sticks in a second because I opened it up half an hour ago. I can do it already.
Right, okay.
And then you and Blammo have to guess who is the creator. So, John, without further ado, please, my friend, get it off the sticks.
Can we mention as well that Blammo's got his own Facebook page now?
Yes, Blammo does have his own Facebook page. If you go and search Blammo and like Blammo and find out what is going on
and
in
also,
the world of Blammo.
Aren't we having like a Facebook competition in the next couple of weeks, John, on World Magic Shop?
Yes.
I love his little face. You throw these things on him and he's just like...
We're having a Facebook competition, so you need to go on and like World Magic Shop.
And like Blammo.
It'll probably be when we move into the new unit.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, because we're moving. We haven't said.
John's got something very strategic planned, haven't you, John?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
We're moving to...
I wish you could see John's face. Right now.
It's good how he can lie. Anyway, this Guess Who game.
Yeah, Guess Who game.
Okay. I honestly don't know.
Okay. And what I'm actually going to use, I'm going to use the creator's patter. Word for word. John,
you're going to do the patter and stuff?
I'm going to use the patter and stuff. thank you, Matthew. I'm going to do the patter and stuff that you actually get. Come in really close. It's a bit angly. Cool. Right.
Right.
When I was a child, I had no friends. At all.
Is this the patter or
this
true?
Is the patter and stuff. It's a bit true as well. When I was a child, I had no friends.
Right, okay.
I also had no pets, despite wanting pets.
Oh.
You know, I never had a Blammo of my own.
Oh, dear.
So instead, I made a friend out of a pack of cards. This is my best friend. He was with me all through school, and to be honest, my best friend still now. His name is Casey. This is Casey. That's Casey's nose, that's Casey's tail. Casey, meet Dave. Casey, meet Blammo. That's Casey, Blammo. There you go, yeah. And first thing we've got to do
is... This is
really the patter. And what we're going to do, we're going to take the cards out of the case. Now, I've actually taught Casey how to do tricks. Are you ready for this? I've called Casey. You don't need the cards. I just need the case because it's not Decky, it's Casey. Okay, so...
Is this really it?
It's really the patter. Right, here we go. Are you ready? Here's the first trick it can do. Stay! Not you. Staying. Isn't that brilliant? Here's another one. Play dead! Look how effective that is. Here's the best one. I can actually get Casey to chase his tail. John, you want to watch this. This is the most amazing thing you've ever seen. Chase your tail, Casey. Chase your tail. Oh, yeah, he's going that way. He's going that way. Oh, he's chasing his tail. He can't get it. He's chasing his tail. He's chasing his tail. Oh, he almost got it. And that is the main trick that Casey can do. And, yeah, that's the trick. That's the one. And you can examine the box and the cards and...
Is it by Craig?
Have a guess, John. You get a
guess who?
And you get a guess. Who do you think it's by, John?
Guess who?
Who do you think it's by?
Daniel Garcia.
You know he watches the show. Danny, I'm so sorry for Dave.
I could just see him doing it.
Daniel Garcia.
I think it's Vegas. Chris Angel.
Chris Angel, you think it's Chris Angel?
No, hang on. No. Think about this,
too. Seriously, think about
it. It's got to be somebody...
I'll give you some... It's somebody very prolific that releases tricks all of the time. He doesn't really have much of a filter. He releases some good stuff. He also releases some very bad... Actually, no, he releases mainly bad stuff.
I know you say this word filter about Jay Sankey.
No, it's not Jay Sankey. It's not Jay. No, not Jay Sankey. Do you want to tell you?
Hang on. If I just went...
That's it. Oh, thank you very much. The trick is by the one, the only, Devon Knight. That's right, yes. Our friend the Wizard Warrior of you, Devon Knight. Now, let me tell you some of the highlights about this trick. First of all, the instructions are so well made. In the age of DVDs and everything like that, you get three pieces of paper with black and white photos on.
This probably trick, though, was out years ago. I remember I saw... In fact, did you go to that lecture with Ali Bongo years ago, John?
Yeah, I think he
gave out the gimmick for free at the start of the lecture to do a spinning note trick, and Paul Daniels opened his show with this.
Well, so
this
is nothing new. According to Devon, this is an effect that he's been doing since 1991, and his inspiration was the original hummus spinning card.
Well,
but he wanted to be able to do that without
I think Ali Bongo came up with the idea.
Yeah, it's
and
like
he did
a
spinning note, because it started with Paul Daniels. On one Paul Daniels show, he started his show and he was like this, and this note just span around in his hand, and then he gave it away. And Ali, I was like 12 or something, Ali Bongo came to our club. Yeah, Ali Bongo came to our club and he gave the gimmicks away at the start of the show, and it had been on the Paul Daniels show the week before.
It reminds me of a very low-tech...
So it goes back before then.
Well, it reminds me of a very low-tech, rubbish version of the trick that Alex Lurido brought out a couple of weeks ago that we reviewed. And I didn't give that a good mark. But there's just no redeeming qualities to this. It reminds me a little bit of iFloat. You know, because it's got that same moment where you think, are you serious? And honestly, I've read the instructions over and over again. That's as good as it gets.
And is that honestly the pattern?
That is honestly the pattern. The performer says, I actually missed out. The performer says some people have pet rots as gimmicks. But
he's got
he's got a pet card case and it's well trained. It's exactly the same. He actually went so far.
He actually does say that's great.
He actually went so far as to put all the scripts in italics. You know, here you go. I have a pet card case, and this is him. His name is Casey. I did the pattern stuff, just like Devon told me to. This is terrible. This is awful.
You're not going to want...
This isn't anything personal towards Devon Knight. This is just not
Is Devon Knight ever going to bring out
We've
a
been
good
doing
trick?
This show
John, is
for
Devon
the last
Knight
year,
ever going to bring
not
out
seen
a good
trick? Devon
Knight.
What?
Apparently there's one coming out.
No, get out. Yeah. What's that?
It is.
Oh, is that the one that everyone's talking about on the cafe? What is it? Four something or
Four
other.
Four Thoughts or something, yeah.
Four Thoughts?
I don't know anything about this. What is...
Apparently it's exactly like mind reading should be.
Really? Who told you that?
I can't remember.
We are looking forward to getting Four Thoughts
You
in.
Know, I will
see
be...
See if we can break them
I will
all.
Be over the moon if we
We'd
actually
love
get
to
a Devon
see something
Knight
great.
That's impressive. I really would.
We'll celebrate. Maybe we should have a premiere when it comes in.
A premiere will be in
tuxedos.
Yeah.
And we'll bring it in and we'll give it the full works.
And then we can have officially every year on the Wizard Product Review Devon Knight Appreciation Day. You know? We all dress up in Elvis Presley costumes and go, oh, thank you very much.
I don't know. Look, I'm never going to do that. I can't review...
You know how it works. You can review it. Please review it.
You wouldn't touch it with a barge pole.
You wouldn't touch it with
you
a little piece
of wood.
You
gave something minus 500%. I know that's really bad. It's stupid how you give minus 500. But how do you... You have to give 0% to something you would never, ever touch in your life. So I'm giving it 0%.
I'm giving it minus 500.
God, it's so stupid, minus 500.
I don't care. It's not good.
Not as stupid as the patter. Just what the magic world needs, another wallet.
Yes, that's it. Magicians and their obsessions with wallets.
This is the, what is that word?
Aleph
wallet. What is that? I thought it said alpha.
It's not alpha, actually.
A-L-E-P-H.
Aleph
wallet. Well, PH is going to be an F, so it's Aleph.
The Aleph wallet. And it's by Vernet Magic, the team that brought us the domino trick recently.
Well, there you go. But I use their TTs all the time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
what this is basically it's a Himba wallet, isn't it? But it's got so much more to offer than just that.
There is so much that you can do with this. It's what they wanted to do, their MO on this, is they wanted to try and put so many different principles into one wallet and then put a DVD together that teaches you how to do a whole stack of different things. And that's what they've accomplished with
this. Okay, so let's, peak.
Well, right, well, peak. First of all, there's a Himba wallet.
Check.
Right, okay. Then you've got a peak, and you've got two different types of peak. You've got an internal peak,
yep.
And you've got an external peak. I'll tell you right now, the SUC principle by Mark Strivings is built into this wallet.
Check.
That's your external peak. But it's also got an internal peak. Now, it's not the normal type of internal peak that you see with, like, stealth assassins. It's a much better internal peak than that, because it uses the Himba principle in order to get the internal peak. And he's very cleverly used a calendar in there, which gives you motivation for reopening the wallet. Now, the other thing about it is you can have this as a magnetic locking wallet or a non-magnetic locking wallet, because what he's done very cleverly is some of the stuff that you've put into the wallet is actually built in with magnets as well. So you can have it as magnetically locking
if
you want.
It also functions as a very, very nice card to wallet as well.
But the beautiful thing
about... And you can load the card in there.
But not only can you load the card in as in a normal card to wallet, it actually appears here inside the see-through sort of part of the wallet.
Well, let's talk about a few... Come back to that, because I want to sort of go a bit overboard on that in a second. But let's talk about a few of the effects that you get, because you get some very interesting cards with it.
X-ray was a very strong effect.
So X-ray, basically, they picked a card, didn't they? And he put some blank sort of photo film in the clear plastic window.
Yeah.
And then they put their hand on it, and he took an X-ray of the card. And when the X-ray came out, you got a card with the five of clubs, like an X-ray image of that card. And it's worth saying you get so many bits
with this. Well, you can see, look at all the bits and pieces you get. Another one is the card to wallet, but not the card to wallet where you load it in with a palm.
Yeah.
The card to wallet where it's behind your back, where you thought that was... Well, it fooled us both.
Yeah, it did fool us. We had no idea how it ended up in the inside pocket.
I've never seen the principle before.
The nice thing is, with his card to wallet routine, which just looked incredible for me, was this moment where... He's doing apparently a card at any number, and he says, right, I'm going to take my credit cards out of the wallet. And he takes his credit cards out of the wallet, so you see this clear.
Yep.
And then he puts this either on their hand or in their pocket.
Yep, totally.
Completely motivated, and then he says countdown to that card.
Yep.
It's not there, and then he makes a magical gesture. They open up the wallet.
Or take it out of their pocket.
And the signed card is now in the wallet.
Staring them in the face.
Signed card, and he can just take it out and hand it to them, the signed card.
He's got two ways of doing that, a palm and a no-palm version. The no-palm version is very clever, the way that he does it. I don't want to give too much away. But the palm version, it works like any normal palm card to wallet, except you can show the wallet empty and then put it into their pocket.
It's absolutely fantastic.
Right, he also gives you... Let's have a look at this. He also gives you
let's talk about a writing pad.
Well, I was going to say, if you add this, it becomes an add a number pad.
You can use it as an add a number pad.
And he's got a wonderful book test using the add a number principle. With
using
a dictionary. Very, very clever. I've never seen that with an add a number routine before. He's also got this, which turns it into a multiple out.
Yeah, don't say too much about that, but it's got a billet index with it that allows up to 16 billets.
16, and he's got a fantastic version of an ESP, and you even get the ESP cards. Gimmick TSP cards, and it's this clean. They literally pick any ESP card, they put it to one side, they don't look at any of them.
You've already shown that you've got one billet, one piece of paper underneath the clear plastic window here.
They pick a card.
Any card.
They look at the bill, they take it out.
You take it out, put it down, unfold it, and it's predicted it.
Absolutely brilliant.
And all this, what's nice...
He's got room service.
It uses another gimmick, which comes with it.
Well, we can say a boon writer.
That comes with it, and that's in the box as well. And you get this kind of like hotel key card, so you can do like a version of Don Wayne's room service.
But using
if
the
you
SUC
like.
Principle, it makes it very, very clean.
Very clean indeed. You're holding the wallet, they give you the three-figure number, then you take it out, you say there's no printing on these cards, and I had a terrible memory, I couldn't remember my room, so I wrote it on the back
so
in Sharpie
stuff.
Pen.
So much
The thing is, you could buy this wallet, and every week you can have a completely different trick.
You could do so many different things with it. It's just absolutely absolutely fantastic. He's got all of these different cards, but then there's the in my opinion, and your opinion as well, the single best trick on the DVD.
The best trick on the DVD. Now, the wallet is great. He goes into so much detail on how to do this routine, and we both said we want to do that. It's worth the price of the wallet, even though it's not cheap. But the effect could close any sort of flying ring routine.
Heck, it could close a competition act.
It is absolutely awesome. And if you've got a residency situation where they have bowls of sugar on the table, this is an absolute killer.
Worth its weight in gold.
Isn't it? The effect is basically you borrow... well, you ask them to choose a sugar packet, first
any
of
sugar
all.
Packet.
That sugar packet is put in the clear window of the wallet, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, not at that point. It's chosen at that point.
It's chosen
it?
At that point. Then, then he borrows a ring. The spectator holds onto the ring.
Yes, the ring vanishes.
Well, no, they are holding onto the wallet before it vanishes.
That's right, yeah.
They're holding onto their borrowed ring.
We'll put some clips on the screen, yeah.
You then take the sugar packet and you put it in the clear compartment of the wallet and you give them that to hold onto in between their
no
hands.
No switch of the sugar packet,
no
it's there.
No switch of the sugar packet, it is there. Then the ring visually vanishes, it's completely gone.
Awesome.
You open up the wallet, inside is still the same sugar packet. You take the sugar packet out, you tear it open. You give it them, they tip it out, in amongst the sugar is the borrowed ring, everything is examinable.
If you just got that one routine and the wallet and with the in-depth teaching with the routine...
Because the DVD is excellent as well.
I'd be happy.
Oh yeah, totally.
But you get all this other stuff as well.
And you could literally put a 20-minute act in your wallet.
You put an hour act together. Yeah, yeah. If you carry that around separately, you could just swap bits around.
But the thing that I want to point out is you don't need to just be set up for one effect and then you can't do any of the others.
No.
You can be set up for most of the effects you can do immediately. So you don't. There's no reset. As soon as you've done the trick, you're ready to go again and again and again. And you can go from routine to routine to routine. Even the sugar packet one would take probably 30 seconds at the most to reset. And that's probably the longest reset of any trick on the DVD.
I know. A lot of people are going to say, you know, it's very expensive. What's the quality like?
The quality is great.
The quality is very good indeed. On the same show as Gypsy Balloon, I thought
there was
going to give Gypsy Balloon Worker of the Week until we looked at this, and now
that's
this
gotta
is
be Worker, of the,
worker
week.
Of the Week. The material on there is absolutely first class.
Yeah.
Although I'm going to give it less than Gypsy Balloon.
It's workable for more people.
It's workable for more people.
Because it's a wallet. It's the sort of wallet that you would carry around with you. It's perfect for an amateur. It's perfect for a hobbyist. We always get that situation where, you know, as a magician, you know, we're out and about and somebody says, hey, show us a trick. And we've always, you know, at some point,
this
every magician
brilliant.
Said, oh, you know, I've got nothing on me. I can't do a trick. If you have this wallet, which you can use to carry your money and your cards
well,
and
look,
everything.
And add a number pad. A decent add a number pad's like 40, 50 quid.
Yeah,
you know?
Totally.
If you bought that one DVD with the sugar thing and the wallet, you'd be looking at 60, 70 quid. Just a very nice wallet with a billet index and a card to wallet and all these things. If you add them up, it's actually really, really good value for money, even though it's not cheap.
Well, look
for
at everything that you get, which is probably about 15 quid on its own.
Yeah, everything you get is very good. I didn't think it was going to impress me, but it has. I'm giving it 93%.
I'm giving it 96%. I think it's probably the best wallet on the market today.
Absolutely brilliant stuff. Right, that's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Matthew, get in here.
We've got Future Buzz Matthew, presented by Matthew Underhill.
Come on,
so
take your time.
So all the members
there
of the Matthew Underhill fan club can now be happy with us for another
week. Right, what's Future Buzz, Matthew?
Photoshop.
What's Photoshop?
You know, have you ever had that situation where you looked at something, like a magazine clipping or something, and you wondered how good it would be just to pull that image out of the magazine clipping?
Well, a bit like render with the iPhone, because that didn't work out too well.
But with Photoshop, you can show like a coin in a magazine clipping and instantly just pull it out.
Seriously?
Is that what everybody says? Is that the buzz on this?
That's what
right, that sounds like something
Does
worth
it come
seeing.
With the DVD?
Yes.
So you got the full pattern stuff?
Yes.
You got the full pattern stuff.
Thing, you know,
so what else? Anything else?
Wave by Dan House.
Oh, he of Restless.
Right,
and,
okay.
And obviously Rattled.
And what's the effect with that?
Basically, you show a card with sort of like some drawings of a sharp marker on.
Right, okay.
And you can instantly, and it just visually changes like a card for like the Four of Hearts or something, the writing that you're writing.
Sounds like the sort of thing you've got to see, though.
Isn't that a paper crane trick?
Yeah.
So we're probably going to have a load of stuff out on the table.
The production values are going to be great, though, aren't they?
Of course they are. It's kept paper crane.
So that sounds pretty good. Don't forget, follow us on Facebook, follow us on YouTube.
Yeah, find us on the Magic Cafe. We're always there arguing back and forth.
Don't forget to, with Michael P. Lair this
week.
Yeah,
yeah. Hello, Michael.
We look forward to your next product.
Yeah.
But that's it from Blammo, from me, Dave.
And from Matthew.
And from Craig.
And that's it for the Wizard Product Review. We really should have rehearsed that, shouldn't we? See you next week.